It's time for another edition of Coach's Corner with women's basketball coach Matilda Mossman.
Hello again, everybody, and welcome to Coach's Corner with head coach Matilda Mossman, University of Tulsa women's basketball. And kind of a rough week, coach. A road trip to Wichita and a road trip to Connecticut. Couple of losses, and probably the common thread is you just didn't shoot it very well, did you?
Yeah, seems to be the common thread all the way through. That Wichita State game, you know, we got off to a great start, shot it well in the first quarter, and then second quarter didn't play as well, but we still had the lead going into halftime. And then we came out in the third quarter, and it was either miss a shot, turn it over, and then Wichita kind of fed off our lack of ability to put the ball in the basket, and then they just started bullying us more than anything, and we didn't bully back, and they started getting some stuff inside. And you know, they didn't shoot a single free throw in the first half, and they ended up shooting 14 for the game. But, you know, we got to the line, too. But they just captured all the momentum, and we couldn't get it back.
Yeah, you're up by 13 at halftime at 28-15. Mm-hmm. What'd you do well in that first half?
Again, first quarter, we really shot it well, and we defended well. I mean, we held them to a low number of points. And, you know, we were doing a lot of things well. And then that second half, the pressure got to us a little bit, and then they're a downhill drive team, and you know, I don't know if maybe in the end we just got a little tired. It's hard to say, but we certainly felt like that one got away from us.
Yeah, that's an opportunity on the road against a team that you can obviously have a good chance to win, Wichita State, and kind of an opportunity missed knowing what you had coming on Sunday with UConn number 4 in the country.
Right, but with Wichita, early in the year, they were struggling, but they had a lot of guys injured and different people out at different times. And I think they're pretty much back to full strength. And they had a couple of guys that it was their second time back or their first time back, and that's really helping them. And as you look at forward, Wichita State just beat Temple on Sunday. So They're really rolling right now. And as we look at the teams that we played in the first five games, we might very well play five of the best teams in the league. And so when you look at it from that perspective, you have to feel good about the fact that you competed with those teams, and then you still got a lot of teams left that you haven't played yet, and some of them you'll play twice. So we still feel pretty good about where we are. We're competing. We're playing hard. It's just a missed shot here, a turnover there. And that's been the difference.
Well, in Wichita State now 3-2, after their win on Sunday. So, indeed, they are playing well. And as inconsistent as your shooting has been, the consistent player for you has been Kendra Nellett. She had a double-double, 16-11 against Wichita State. You can almost bank on something close to that every game, right?
You pretty much can. And, you know, that was big for her because she's played at Wichita South High School. And so she was going back home for the last time in her Tulsa career. And that meant a lot to her to be there playing on that court, same court that she won 4 straight state championships on. So a pretty meaningful night for her.
Yeah, and you didn't shoot free throws well. I mean, it probably could have helped you out just a little bit. 8 of 15 from the line. Get a few of those, and you might be really in the game at the end.
Huh? Yeah, I think it says something about your team when your 6'2 post player is your best percentage three-point shooter. That's probably not a good thing. But, you know, again, we're getting extra shots. We're doing everything we can offensively to put people in the right position. We're getting open shots, and sometimes that becomes a mental thing. You start hesitating because you've missed a couple, but I think our guys have got to get to the point where if you're not hitting shots early, you've got to do more attacking. You've got to get to the free throw line. And then, of course, you have to hit free throws.
And defensively, you're not playing that poorly. Obviously, Sunday is a little bit of an anomaly. Right. But defensively, you're not doing that badly, are you?
No, we're not. And we're not even counting the UConn game on Sunday. I mean, they're the number 4 team in the country. They had been playing poorly on the road. And then all of a sudden, as a staff, we felt like we were sitting ducks on Sunday. We felt like this is not good for us because they've played poorly. They've played 2 close games against conference opponents. Geno's all over them. They had the game before that, they had lost to Baylor at home and ended, you know, like a big winning streak at home. So everything was stacked against us. I mean, we were at the wrong place at the wrong time. So. But it was an opportunity to you know, play some younger guys that hadn't been playing as much. And then really in the second half, it was more about we don't want our top 5 guys to get injured. And so, you know, it could have been a 40-point game, but because we held Kindred out for pretty much, you know, most of the second half, we held Lexus out, we held Rebecca out, held Maddie Biddle out. Those guys just have played so many minutes, and we're going to need them on Tuesday against East Carolina. So, you know, it's just like they're playing. I mean, and UConn played probably their best game of the year. They were unbelievable.
Well, and your best quarter was the third quarter. So, I mean, at least you came out at halftime and very competitive that quarter, right?
Well, yeah, again, that's the thing about this team. They don't get down. They don't stop competing. They're continuing to play hard, and no matter what the circumstances are. So, you know, we've just got to stay, you know, keep them with us. You know, don't get your heads down. Don't worry about what has happened in the past. Let's look forward to Tuesday against East Carolina. Let's look forward to Saturday against SMU.
Well, they say don't poke the bear. The bear got poked, but it wasn't you guys doing the poking, but you got the wrath of the bear. And plus the fact that you've always played pretty well, you know, whether it's Hartford or Storrs, Connecticut, against them, have held your own against them. And I'm sure Gino probably talked to them about, hey, Tulsa's played pretty good in here. You know, we gotta go get it done. And they obviously, as you said, play their best game.
Yeah, and the reason we've played well against UConn in the past is we shot the three ball well. I mean, every time we played them, we shot the three ball well. And obviously, we did not shoot. We had not been shooting it well, so we weren't thinking we were going to go in there and just be lights out. But again, our effort was good, and we were definitely at the wrong place at the wrong time.
Yeah, the effort was there. The atmosphere was great. Probably a great experience for the kids, but unfortunately, a loss for the Golden Hurricane. And now TU gets ready for a home game on Tuesday against ECU. We'll talk about that in a moment when we continue on Coach's Corner.
Be undeniable.
We're back on Coach's Corner with head coach Matilda Mossman. And again, you wipe the slate clean and get ready for a home game this week, Tuesday taking on ECU. 7 o'clock start at the Reynolds Center, so we will see you there. And coach, what about ECU?
Well, they're a very athletic team, and I think their record is a little bit deceiving. They've got a couple of new kids who are trying to blend in, and they got a new coaching staff. And I know back at our meetings back in October, Media Day, Coach McNeil made the comment that all of our players are freshmen because none of them know our system. None of them have done this before with our staff. So, you know, those guys compete. They'll pick you up full court. They've got a nice little 1-2-2 full court press, and they'll trap and they'll create turnovers. They're creating something like 20 some turnovers a game. And so that makes you a little nervous because you do have to get the ball across half court. You do have to get into your offense, and they make that really tough.
And as you approach this week, you know, a chance, as you mentioned, with the tough early schedule, a chance now to make some hay. And so I don't know if the pressure is on, but certainly you feel you have some opportunities here this week.
Absolutely. And, you know, just getting back home and playing a team that it's not on the rise like Wichita was. They were definitely on the rise. And you mentioned Wichita had two losses. One of those was to Connecticut.
Right.
So, you know, I think that skews the win-loss record. But East Carolina is certainly hungry for a win. They were at Houston on Sunday, and so they've had a little bit of a travel, just like we've had to travel. And it's going to be competitive on Tuesday.
Speaking of travel, back on the road at Dallas against SMU coming up on Saturday. I know you're just concerned with the Tuesday game, but SMU-Tulsa games usually are pretty darn good.
Yeah, and it's a nice little rivalry. It's a, you know, close enough game, and we do a lot of recruiting in the Dallas area, so it's, you know, we want those guys to come to the game, and you know, SMU is recruiting a lot of those same people, so it's a chance for them to watch us in action, and it's a chance for even our families to be able to travel there. We've got some families down in Dallas, Rebecca Lasky, and and Kayla Moutry, and even though Maddie Washington's not playing with us this year, her mom and dad are down there. So it's a good atmosphere, and we've always had some really good games.
2 p.m. Saturday for the Golden Hurricane on the road at SMU. Coach, have a great week.
All right, thanks, Bruce.
Don't forget, 7 o'clock on Tuesday, TU taking on ECU at the Reynolds Center. We'll see you here at the Reynolds Center, and we will see you next week, next time on Coach's Corner with Head Coach Matilda Mossman. So long, everybody.